Hello Pluto fans, I'm Panagiotis, a developer of Pluto, and today I'm going to talk to you about Pluto, dashboards and Excel, how we can get inspired from the best computer program out there. In this talk, we'll explore what makes Excel the best program out there, why people are using it, what people want from their computational assistant, and how Pluto compares. And which upcoming features are going to make Pluto much, much better and much, much more useful for everyone. Okay. First of all, let's see who we're developing for. Let's assume Marlene, a teacher of technology to 13-year-old students. Marlene is a tech-savvy teacher at her local school. She has been working very hard during the pandemic to create videos for all the classes. She doesn't know how to code and she uses Google Forms for online tests. It's hard for her to keep students interested during teleteaching. So, for a user like Marlene, how can Pluto help? It actually can't. If we added native browser support and data entry capabilities, she would be able to fill tables and reference these from Julia and actually use the data. Then we would lower the bar and we could possibly make it easier for Marlene to feel comfortable and use Pluto and Julia in the classroom. Our next imaginary user is Nikki. Nikki is an analyst at a local company sales team. She's a star analyst. She's very fluent at Excel, VBA, and PowerPoint. She would love to run some analysis, maybe in SQL or something, but she doesn't really know how. So her everyday life looks like the following. She updates some Excels, she puts the new numbers into a PowerPoint, hits the export button, makes a new email, and sends the updated data. Due to company policy, she cannot really install any new software. So, how can Pluto help Nikki? It can't. It can't because Nikki cannot install any new software. The IT is very strict. But if we added native browser support and added some data entry capabilities like filling tables and changing data from inside Pluto, and also, if we could make it super easy for her to add all her data into Pluto with a friendly UI. And finally, if we added some dashboard building capabilities so she can tweak the layout without very much fuss, then Nikki would be able to leverage Pluto's beauty and do Excel automations in Julia. Then sending PDF exports would be trivial. Finally, let's think of Panagiotis. So Panagiotis is a software engineer and he really likes to dive into data. Where he works, there is a Postgres with a lot of data and he likes to run the analysis and to explain the data. So how does an analysis look like? First, you do the analysis, then you have to explain it, and then you share the data. And you need to send it somewhere that people can actually access it, like your internal customers or something. That's the process, unless you're doing machine learning, of course, where you skip the explanation step and shout, ML is not explainable to everybody. A side note is that if you all watched Connor's talk, you know that if you have Connor on your team, you can also deploy your Pluto-based analysis without rewriting it. Okay. Back to our theme. Our theme is Excel, and let's do Excel stuff in Pluto. What do people do with Excel? The most common thing, contrary to the popular belief, is to create lists. So adding a list is pretty easy. You can do it in Markdown, so this is a tree, and that's a new list. So people love keeping lists in Excel, and we can do that in Pluto, easy. So another thing people do in Excel is their taxes. Here we use a Pluto UI text field. we add some prices, and then we add the tax, and then we calculate a total price. That was also easy, but you know, it can be better. So let's actually compare a real analysis and see if we can make a dashboard out of it. So let's assume some data that we've downloaded from the Open API for the weather above Athens. And let's see how would you do that in the Excel. So usually you would open up Excel and it works, and you would open a pivot table on a new sheet, boom, boom, done. And then you analyze dragging and dropping fields. That's a nice UI. Let's see how we would do that in Pluto. So first, we would download some data that I have uploaded to Google Sheets, and we would csv.read file data frame. Now, that's not a big deal if you have seen that before. So there is definitely room for improvement. Let's try to create a pivot table. If we group by the base, it's 645 stations. If we pivot by a description, we can see that Greece has clear sky, few clouds, some clouds, and that's, you know, the winter, so that's nice. And the list goes on. It actually is pretty, it's pretty easy once you get comfortable with it. Okay, so let's make a chart. This is the chart of temperatures since the August 2020, so most of the pandemic. This looks really nice, but what would you do if you needed to use all the space you have on the screen? Let's see the new feature we're developing. We click on this little button, and now loading, and all our cells are everywhere. We quickly skip through the first cells and go to the analysis. Okay, so we have a title cell, we have our other cells that we may or may not need, and with this new feature, we can actually create the 2D layout that works for us. And I think you will agree with me that this is very, very nice. Okay, so we can relay out all these things. We can zoom out to make it more visible. So with this new feature, you can actually have a dashboard like the one you're used to from maybe Metabase or Superset or Grafana or all these things. Let's get back to editing. So with this new feature and with all this discussion, what's the gist? So what do people do with their computing tools? They input data, they input lists, they send files, they create informative reports, they analyze, export data, they debug code, and they use user interfaces to analyze easier. So how does Pluto compare? Pluto is pretty good with lists, not so good with data, not so good with standalone files, but stay tuned for new features coming really soon about reproducible and cool notebooks. You just saw the 2D grid layout, which is work in progress and will help you create informative reports. And of course, we have a lot of stuff in the pipeline with cell dependency visualization and some tricks Fons is preparing to debug code even easier. So what's the bottom line of all this? If you have solved the normal people problems, which are these five, the installation, how do you get data in, where do you run the code, how do you deploy, and how do you authorize, Then Pluto is already the best tool out there, and with the features we're building, it's going to be even better. Because you can write analysis, you can add explanations, you can add reactivity. Now you can add 2D layout, and all of that without losing Git and with the ability to export in PDF, HTML, or REST. So stay tuned. Good things are coming. Thank you very much.
Thanks so much, Panayoti.
Thank you.
That was really cool. The reactions on YouTube were great. Super. I have a bit of delay, so I don't know if there are any questions yet.
Thank you, everyone. Okay, so one friend of mine asked me what happened to Marlene. I think we have we need to lower the bar a bit more for Marlene to use Pluto. Yeah. It would be great if she could make a class or something that she would use interactivity and show things to kids. Because imagine the computational thinking, but, you know, 8 years earlier, if you have children 13 years old. So that was the inspiration, that there are people out there who really could use tools like that, but we have to make it easier for them.
Yeah, and like how?
One big bar is installation, I think. Mm-hmm. And the other one, but you know, if you know Marlene, like I do, you can fix that for her. The next big thing is to make UIs for stuff that people use often. Like also Amit asked before in the previous talk, I think UIs for stuff that happen often would really help people without much experience to get into the code and get starting. And we have seen that they will build amazing stuff after that. Like, get them in, they will flourish.
Yeah.
Just seeing that there are quite some comments and suggestions regarding the 2D layout, which looks really, really amazing. One question is, or one suggestion is to have it in the standard layout in the beginning when you activate it, and then only change the order when you pull the windows and change the window sizes.
Exactly. I have to say that it's very much work in progress. And before the talk, I have moved the cells to positions that they look nice. So there isn't any initial smart thing to lay out stuff yet, but we're working on it.
Okay. And is the layout then safe?
Maybe on JuliaCon. Maybe on JuliaCon we will announce something really smart and really nice.
Mm. Is the layout saved in the notebook file then? When you close it and open it again?
Currently it's on local storage, but okay. I'm trying to decipher fonts algorithm for PKG and do the same, so it will be part of the notebook file, yes.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, more about this tomorrow.
Exactly.
Perfect. Sounds great.
Yeah, I mean, I think we've talked about this for hours, of course. I think this would be really cool. You talked about how we can make it accessible to beginners. And I think when we have our developer calls, we often talk about Excel. It's really something that we should take inspiration from and that we do take inspiration from. Okay, let's go to the next talk, which is the second to final talk. We decided to add one more talk at the end of of today, which is kind of a preview of what our Pluto developer calls are like. So every Thursday at 6, we have the Pluto developer call. It's open, anyone can join. And we have like a little snippet to give you a feel for what it would be like to join. So that one is coming after the talk by Matt Bauman, which is coming right now. So see you at the next talk.
Bye.